Hi, welcome back to The Shtick. We're in the studio with Jeffrey Appel, OAM, who is telling us about the services the Jewish Care provides. Welcome back to the show.
Thanks, Henry. Good to be back again.
So, where do you start? I mean, this is amazing. My family came to Melbourne in 1958 under the Jewish Welfare and Relief. My dearly departed uncle, Pinkus Grossman, who would have been 100 years old today. So this is dedicated to Pinkus Grossman, and he sponsored us to come out. And we lived in the welfare relief house in what's the street called?
Herbert Street.
Yep. Lived in Herbert Street.
Opposite
Elwood Shore. Best position in Melbourne. How could we landed on our feet, but there were five other families living in one house. Oh. And there were four of us, my sister Esther and my parents lived in one room. Five families sharing one kitchen.
Jewish Welfare had two blocks of apartments in that street.
And they sold it. Yep. Schmucks. Why did they sell it?
Well, we had to do other things.
What a great position.
The community had demands. It had needs.
Yeah.
You know.
So you do a lot of work, especially in the... tell us just some of the stuff that you...
Wow, they do a lot of work.
I know where to start.
Well, where do we start? Well, we provide a lot of social services. We provide...
Like in employment?
We have an employment provision. Mm. We help people do their CVs, how to present for jobs, try and connect them with jobs, and we're doing really well.
So that's employment,
Employment. But we also, leading as part of that area of helping people establish themselves, we've got Empower Loans.
That's right, it's a free interest. Interest-free.
And it used to be called, which is very common around the world, in the Jewish community, it used to be the Mutual Loan Company.
That's right, I remember that. My father borrowed from them many, many years to start his first business.
Well, John Seri, who you know.
Dr. John Seri.
Dr. John Seri.
Hello, John. We love your work.
He's been involved in that and led it and run it, and it's amazing.
Yeah.
I mean, in this last financial year, I think we've done something like 1.6 million out in loans.
In loans.
Something like 22 has gone to people helping them start up their own businesses. Mm-hmm. There's been maybe 19 have gone to debt consolidation. I mean, people...
Yeah,
I know. It's pretty tough out there at the moment. And, you know, Jewish Care's there to try and help.
Yes.
So, you know, there's been a lot of work in that area. And we're very fortunate that we have got, again, people in our community who find it important to give by way of donation money which is set aside specifically for Empower Loans.
Tell us about Yesod.
Yesod, that's a great program.
Great program.
That's, I think, in its fourth year.
That's for young people.
Young people, and it's the age of the people are around probably 25 to 40.
Right.
And its aim is to really train the next generation of leaders in our community.
And working in NFPs, not-for-profits.
Not-for-profits. And we do that in conjunction with the Australian Institute of Company Directors.
Right.
It's around about a nine-month course.
Uh-huh.
Each, we take 12 people. Thrilled to say that we have something like 30 apply.
Mm-hmm.
And
every year?
Every year.
Yeah, so it's a 12-month.
Involved process of deciding who's going to be the 12.
Right.
And each person is then assigned to, linked up with a director who becomes that person's mentor for the period. They join one of the subcommittees.
Mm-hmm.
They get the opportunity to attend a board meeting.
That's an amazing opportunity.
Outstanding.
For young people.
Outstanding. And hopefully they go on and get involved in not-for-profits, whether within the Jewish community or outside. But it's really training the next stage of leaders.
Fantastic. And what else can we say that you do, which is disability,
home help? Home help. You know, we have
many
people.
All the Russian people?
Well, not only Russians. There's lots of people who need daily assistance, need home help.
Right. Rather than going into a home, they have home help.
And there is the large number of Holocaust survivors that we have in our community.
That's right.
And we have the Claims Conference, which provides funding, which assists in enabling people to live in their own home as long as possible. And it's the quality of life that they
And that's related to Holocaust survivors?
Yes.
And you also work in conjunction with the Holocaust Centre?
We have relationships with all organisations. Mm. We try to be involved where possible, and where others are doing services, there's no need to replicate the services.
No.
One needs to be very prudent and careful how one spends the funds that we either receive through our annual appeal, which...
Talking about annual appeal, you had an amazing annual dinner.
We did.
Where
you
actually raised $3.2 million.
We did.
Appeal.
We did very well, and thank you to the community who, again, very generously supported Jewish Care in all its endeavours, and we managed to raise this year $3.2 million.
And your son, as you mentioned, Rowan. He got up and did the shtick.
He did the shtick. Rowan also did the Yesod program.
Yesod, he did it as well.
And in his profession, he's an architect, and he's now on the building subcommittee. So providing his knowledge as an architect back to the community, because with all these projects we're doing, we need people who have got skills and can provide those services. So, yes, the appeal was very successful.
And you have another son called Dion.
You know Dion.
Yeah, I know Dion, who's married to Kylie Appel, who's been on the shtick.
Who works with Tom.
That's right, with Tom Makers.
Yeah.
So we've had Kylie on the show.
We'll have to get you Gavin.
While we're mentioning, Gavin's coming on, I'm sure.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Definitely. I'll tell you one thing we have to mention is your CEO, who is Bill Appleby. There's a magazine here that comes out twice a year, My Connection.
Yep.
And there's a cover photo of Bill with Susie, who's on recently. Susie Ivan, he's vice president.
She's vice president,
With Mike Dubinsky.
He's president.
Who is the president. And in the centre of the photo is somebody we haven't mentioned yet.
Oh, we did.
Did we mention Charlie?
I thought just before we were talking about the buildings.
Oh, yeah, we did. Charles Holkner.
Amazing gentleman.
Amazing man who's given you a few million bucks. That's right.
He has indeed.
We did mention that.
Yes, wonderful.
And who else do we have to mention? I'd like to mention Andrew Blody, who, along with you, is a life governor.
Yes.
And several other people we won't mention now because we're running out of time. But look, Jewish Care really does care. To
very
a degree
so.
There. I've heard things where people have been unhappy.
Happens in everything.
Exactly.
There's always some that are unhappy. We hope we can make them happy.
Look, taking this on is amazing, like the amount of work that you do. And we've only touched the surface, by the way.
We help something like 6,000 families.
I know.
It's huge.
It's huge.
And it's a privilege and it's an honour to be involved with such a wonderful organisation and the people that work for it and provide their time, whether it's in providing services, whether it's volunteering, providing funding.
We forgot to mention the volunteers, which is like the backbone of your...
And in a couple of weeks, we're having the Staff and Volunteers Award Night, which is a wonderful event every year.
Fantastic. And we must mention as we go out your lovely wife Sue Appel, who is very much involved in Israeli dancing.
She's been teaching Israeli folk dancing with horror for the last 30 years.
It's a horror show.
It's a horror. It's horror.
But spelled H-O-R-A.
It is indeed. And they're wonderful.
Fantastic. And as we go out, I'll have to lead into who's coming on next. And that's a lovely young lady called Karen Green.
I know Karen.
Who you know. You know her father, who's part of the folk dancing troupe.
Yes.
And she's coming on next to talk about her Zumba shtick and also personal training.
She might get you to do a bit of Zumba.
I'm right into it. I'm going to start doing Zumba because I've had a very unfit winter. Now we're coming on to spring. We'll be back after the break with Karen Green. And I'd like to thank you once
Thanks,
again
Henry.
So much for coming on.
It's a pleasure.
True gentleman.
Thank you.
Thank you.